take them all to bed, but again, I'm going to go back real quick. Whenever that dot is on, it's recording. And when it's green, it's off.
Thank you. afternoon that God has had in mind for a long, long time. You know, he orchestrated you two getting together from way before we were ever born. And while Todd, while you were in your mom's room, and Christy, while you were in your mom's room, God began first as individuals, then your relationship with him, and then bringing you two together so that on this day, we could be surrounding the two of you in a house of worship as God does something very special. And that is, he does a miracle of causing a man and woman to become a husband and a wife. And so, as we begin this service, we would like to pray. So join with me, everybody, as we pray. Father, thank you so much for this very, very special place and this time. We come before you in awe and with humbleness. Because, Lord, we're here in awe because of you being the great God and King that you are. We come to you in humbleness because we're going to witness a tremendous miracle here in our midst. And that is you creating, going from a man and a woman to a husband and a wife. Lord, we pray that you would set aside this place and make it holy ground. And that right now, Father, by your Spirit, you would begin the process of joining these two together. And so we give you this time and give you this place. Lord, we just surround this with our prayers. In your name we pray. Amen. Be seated.
But you guys have put in a lot of hard work over the last 3 months.
months as we've been together. It has been a lot of fun. And as I was thinking and praying about it, it's like, God, what would you want me to say to them? Kind of as a coach does before the team heads out onto the field. Because in a way, I've kind of been your coach for the last 3 months. And so I think he's given me two things that he wants me to share with you. And I'm going to do them in reverse order, kind of like the Dave Letterman countdown. So instead of the top 10, it's the top 2. And these are the top 2 parting shots that God wants me to share with you. Number 2 is this. Remember the 5 love languages. And remember each other's love language. And use it regularly. Okay. Now you guys remember each other's love language, right? For those who don't know about us, I'm just going to give you a brief recap. We've been using a book that's by Gary Chapman called 5 Love Languages. And for most of you who are close friends, they analyzed your lives. Before they could talk about their love languages, they talked about the people in their lives as we tried to figure out so they could see different people's love languages. And we talked about moms and dads and friends. And then we talked about the two of you. And you guys both know each other's love language. And what Gary Chapman's found out is that the unique love language, there's 5 primary ones. And that's the way we hear the other person say, I love you. Now, we can try to say it in our own love language, but if it's not the same as the other person's, it doesn't come across the same way. And so it's very easy to just fall back into little patterns and try to say, I love you, with your own love language, but if you don't have the same love language. And so what I'm going to challenge you to do is to remember the other person's love language. So I'm going to put you on the spot, Todd. I'm going to have you whisper to Christy what your love language is. Turn around and whisper to me. Okay? Now, Christy, I'm going to have you whisper in Todd's ear what your love language is. And so there's several aspects of becoming one that you guys need to be aware of. You know, the easy one is, you know, one flesh. We need to make sure that all of a sudden now we go from thinking of me to we. And so there's that one aspect. All the rest of the decisions you're going to make from the rest of your life from this impact will be and not me. And so I'd like you just to look at each other and say the word we. Maybe we worked a lot of doing all this stuff. But anyhow, you're going to be great at that. But I just want you to remember that there's that oneness, that there's transformation that's taking place. But that's just one aspect of oneness. The other aspect actually goes to what Glenn read in Scripture and what Jesus was talking about. And granted, he was talking about his followers being one. But he wants us to be one with him. And so there's an aspect of the oneness that you two are going to have that can only be made in his completeness as you are one with Christ. And the way that that's going to work is the way it's been working up to this point, which is Todd, you work on your relationship with Christ so you draw one with him. Chris, you work on your relationship so you are one with Christ. And then what you two together is work on your, as a couple, as a husband and wife relationship with Christ, so that the two of you are one with Christ, just like Christ was with the Father. And as you do that, it's amazing the things that he will do in your life and through your lives. So the two parting points, one, 5 love languages, and then the other one is really work on that oneness with Christ, still as individuals, but also as a couple. We're going to pray for you right now. thank you for Todd and Christy's love languages. And I pray that you would help them to be so conversant in those love languages that not a day would go by that Christy does not know that Todd loves her. And that Todd knows that he would always know. And Lord, for this oneness, first off, I thank you for the blessing that it is for these two to be brought together. And we pray that they would have a fabulous oneness physically. Lord, we pray that they would have a fabulous oneness emotionally as they move from me to we. And Lord, that you would be ever with them in their oneness with you as individuals and as God. Lord, if they do those things, Lord, they'll have a happy, long, blessed marriage. So we, as family, friends, pray this prayer that you would cause these very things to happen. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Still want to go through this? Okay. In that case, Todd, do you take Christy to be your wife? And in the presence of these witnesses, do you promise that you will do everything in your power to make your love for her a main part of your life? Will you continue to strengthen it from day to day and week to week with the best resources of your being? And will you stand by her in sickness or in health, in poverty or in wealth? And will you shun all others and keep yourself to her alone as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do.
I do.
And Christy, do you take time to meet your husband? And in the presence of these witnesses, do you promise that you will do everything in your power to make your love for him a growing part of your life? Will you do it from day to day and week to week with the best resources of your being? And will you stand by him in sickness or in health, in poverty or in wealth? And will you shun all others and keep yourself to him alone as long as you both shall live? So say, I do. Very good. You'll hand your flowers over and face each other. Or let Pete take care of the dress. You've got to make you look pretty. Todd, we're going to start with you. Christy, what love I take you.
Christy, what love I take you.
To be my beloved bride.
To be my beloved bride.
My dearest friend.
My dearest friend.
My treasured companion.
My treasured companion.
My wife.
My wife.
I promise to love you and lead you.
I promise to love you and lead you.
To encourage you to care for you.
To encourage and care for you.
I will lead our home.
I will lead our home.
As Christ leads me.
As Christ leads me.
As Christ does for us.
As Christ does for us.
I will share every part of my life with you.
I will share every part of my life with you.
I will be to your needs.
I will be sensitive to your needs.
I will be understanding when you hurt.
I will be understanding when you hurt.
I will keep the secrets that you share with me.
I will keep the secrets that you share with me.
I promise to provide you.
I promise to provide you.
With an abundance of positive encouragement.
With an abundance of positive encouragement.
To respect your judgment.
To respect your judgment.
And listen, and to listen when you speak. Most of all, Christy, I promise to continue loving you without reservation.
I promise to continue loving you without reservation.
As no other man on earth could love you.
No other man on earth could love you.
By God's grace and power.
By God's grace and power.
I will be true and faithful to you.
I will be true and faithful to you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
I love you. Todd, I love you.
Todd, I love you.
And I'm honored to become your wife. That Jesus Christ has brought us together.
You are a man
after God's own heart.
And I'm confident
that you will be a loving spiritual leader. To love you as God does,
I must rely on
Him. I promise to continue my walk with Jesus Christ. Become the woman He has called me to be. Todd, I promise to be faithful to you.
Todd, I promise to be faithful to you.
To respect and trust your decisions.
To respect and trust your decisions.
I promise to submit to your leadership.
I promise to submit to your leadership.
And look forward to making our home.
And I look forward to making our home.
A place of refuge for you.
A refuge for you.
A home full of laughter.
A home full of laughter.
Joy and prayer.
Joy and prayer.
Todd, I believe in you.
Todd, I believe in you.
I am committed to our future. You are my best friend.
Lord,
as this comes to a close. Again, we just thank you for bringing these two together and for being here in our midst today. Father and Son and Holy Spirit, as we leave this place, go with them. And Lord, let the celebration begin. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, you're supposed to kiss your bride, aren't you? So, Todd, you can go ahead and kiss your bride.
Thank you. Okay, Glenn Malone. Glenn Malone. Your car's double.
Okay.
Trees of green, red roses too, I keep burning you. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself,
I hope you know somebody loves you and wants
the same things too. Yeah, this is my.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
They're in the car. It's in the car.
Did it? Are you in?
Ooh, Glenn.
Get her in there.
Glenn. Is there? Yeah, I couldn't figure it out. Whoa!
Touch shoes.
Oh, they flip.
Woohoo!
Stay out of the street,
hold
though.
That.
Stay right here.
Hold get your
this.
Turn around. Get these behind you. Yeah. Get these behind you.
Where do you think the light is? Where do you think the light is?
It's right there.
That open it up? Oh, that opens it up.
Oh, that's the table open up. I've never really used it. Look at that.
That's no, right it's his power LCD. Woo-hoo!
Hey, big chicken!
Chicken! Do it! Christy!
A little bit.
Hey, Christy, look up there.
Christy, look there. You go.
There we go.
Look up there.